Gopher was released on the Atari 2600 by US Games in 1982. You play as a farmer who is protecting his carrot patch from a hungry and pesky gopher. The gopher will dig its way under the ground, quickly wandering around back and forth before digging its way up. Your goal is to fill the holes it digs, or give him a bonk with your shovel if you can catch it once it makes its way to the surface. Otherwise, it might slip past you and snag away one of your carrots, which serves as a life. Once you run out of carrots, it's game over. The gopher won't always go straight for the surface, though. Sometimes it just burrows through for a bit and then goes back to start a new tunnel. You can't fill a hole until it reaches the top, so if there are multiple paths, you'll end up playing a cat and mouse game, going back and forth between filling holes, and directly guarding him from getting to your carrots. Because the gopher is a lot faster than you, this chase can be quite problematic, as he can dig holes faster than you can fill them. So take advantage of any opportunity you can if he's wandering around on the bottom to get the holes plugged up. Because the more holes there are, the more options he has, and then you're running around like a chicken with its head cut off. Aside from the shovel, you don't get any weapons or special attacks, but occasionally a duck will fly back dropping a seed. If you catch one and plant it in a spot where a carrot was stolen, a new one will grow, essentially giving you an extra life. There's no way in hell that this game wasn't inspired by the subplot in Caddyshack, where Bill Murray's character Carl Spackler deals with a gopher fucking up the golf course. This is obvious, especially when you consider the cheeky nature of this gopher, who is obviously messing with you, even sometimes poking his head out of the ground just to give you shit. It's too bad that the game didn't incorporate anything else from Caddyshack, though, like explosives or something. Because while this is a decent game with an interesting enough of a concept, well-rendered graphics, and a decent amount of replay value, there's also a lack of variety. It would have been nice to get a special attack or two, maybe a special item aside from the seeds, or other obstacles or hazards. There's not even much in the way of game variations. There's just an option whether or not to include the seed-dropping duck. And there's a two-player alternating mode. Gopher had a chance to be an underrated obscurity, but instead, it's a fine, average, run-of-the-mill obscurity.